guys, it's Angie here from the Lean Girl Guide. If any of you have been following my Instagram over the past couple of weeks, you will see that I've been traveling almost every weekend, and this coming weekend I'm off again. So I decided to do a video on how I managed to still stay on track, still stick to my diet, and stay active while I'm traveling or while I'm not actually at home and in my normal routine. So here are four tips on how to do so. So firstly, I do take probiotics every single day. This helps to normalize your digestive system, and often this is the first thing that actually plays up when you're traveling or when you're not in your normal routine, eating the normal foods that you would be eating and exercising at the same time. So generally your body gets into a certain rhythm and it expects you to be eating certain foods. So if you're now all of a sudden eating something completely different, a good probiotic is a great way to still try and keep your body normalized, especially when you're traveling overseas. A lot of people start having stomach issues, eating different food, where it could also be the water. So try and take your probiotic with you. If you're not taking one, then I would suggest that you go and invest in one and take that daily. So try and keep as many things constant as you can. So that would be one of them. Secondly, obviously when it comes to diet, it's a lot more difficult when you are presented with beautiful snacks in your hotel room, or whether you're at a conference and there's, you know, a beautiful breakfast buffet and then snacks and then lunch and then snacks and then dinner. It is quite difficult to say no. So a couple of things that I do is, first of all, I like to plan the day. So if I know I'm gonna have a beautiful dinner at a fancy restaurant with some wine and dessert, then my other two meals in the day will be smaller and lower calorie. So for example, if I'm gonna be having a big dinner, then for breakfast I'll just have something simple like some egg whites and some whole grain toast and maybe a bit of avo. And try and keep it quite small, and then I will not have a snack in the morning, and then at lunch again I'll have a nice light salad with some protein to keep me satisfied, and then I can indulge in the evening and have some wine, have some dessert. Life is no fun if you don't get to indulge sometimes, so you don't always have to restrict yourself. What I normally come to terms with while I'm traveling is that I'm not going to maybe lose weight, but at least maintain and not backtrack to where I was before. So maybe say to yourself, okay, this week I'm just gonna try and maintain, and then try and balance out your meals as I've recommended. Then a third thing is we need to watch out for the alcohol. So same again, whether you're on conferences, normally when people get together they have lots of drinks, lunch, dinner, and of course when you're on holiday too, the cocktails are coming out, all of the sugary drinks. Now, there are two problems with this. Firstly, alcohol is very high in calories and sugar and tends to also mess with your body's balance. So try and drink a lot of water in between if you are planning on drinking quite a bit. And then try and stick to the less sugary drinks. So whether that's a glass of champagne, a glass of wine, or also try some whiskey with some soda water, and try and limit yourself to one to two drinks, because if you're not eating like you normally are and you're drinking a hell of a lot more, your body is definitely not going to stay the same, and you're going to end up backtracking to where you were a couple of weeks back. Unfortunately, you know, a good 2 weeks of holiday and eating and drinking as much as you like can set you back quite a bit. So try and limit yourself, and if you can, try not drink every single day. Rather say, you know, for 2 days you're not going to have anything, and then indulge a bit on the third. And then lastly is to try and stay active as much as possible. So if there's a hotel in your gym, I normally try and choose hotels that do have a gym, just because you're not sure how the weather will be. So I like to at least know that I can do a 20-minute session in the gym. There are so many workouts out there that you don't actually need a gym though, so you can bring along a skipping rope, you can do some type of workout, and that only needs 20 to 30 minutes, and I find that that really sets me off well for the day. If I don't sweat, I'm miserable. So, and also if you're going to a place that has beautiful scenery, plan a run, plan a walk, and make sure that you're still staying active, especially if it's going to be quite a relaxing holiday and you're planning on lying down in the sun for most of it. Still try and get active for about 20 to 30 minutes at least every single day. So for those of you who are planning your holidays, don't stress. You know, incorporate these couple of tips, and I'm sure you'll be able to keep your body. It's not just about getting there, but it's about maintaining it. So I hope these couple of tips have helped. You can also head down to theleanGirlGuide.com and you can find some more tips, tricks. You can sign up there for my weekly blog. Otherwise, have a fantastic week. Let's get a little bit leaner. Summer is about 3 months away. It's actually already here, it seems. So let's get our leanest bodies ever, girls.